So we kick off with the women's juniors. It's England versus Scotland. England on the inside, Scotland in the blue on the outside. Here we go.
Well, we'd love to bring you the confirmed quartet, but keep an eye out for the red flags from the officials on the outside of the track, because they are very eagle-eyed and they can spot anything that is marginal or clearly out of sync. A rivalry like no other. England in the 20s, Scotland in the 20s, the junior 4 by 100 metres away nicely as they power around this first bend, and England just have the edge at the moment. It's a nose really. Can they keep it clean? Remember, it's a guaranteed silver medal, and it's a bit of a late pass, but England have got it away. And as they go down that back straight, England starting to storm past Scotland now, and it's whites versus the blues, and it's clean from both of them, although Scotland have just gone out the exchange zone. It's England leading at the moment as they come into the home straight. Scotland might have got that late, but it just seems to be inside the markings. England storming away with this one then. They're not going to get caught. England on home patch, the Manchester International, 46.95 on the clock. And that is the win for England. That is the gold medal, and that is more points for the England team. Well, a couple of them, I was a bit worried at one point that we might only have one finishing team. I didn't spot any red flags. This is the replay. Well, for Scotland, it was Leila Dewill on the first leg. She got off really well. England just closing the gap slightly, and we can have a bit more of a detailed look here at these changeovers and see if you can spot the markings on the track, the exchange zones. Both done nicely. Love to see a second leg in a 4x100 down the back straight. England storming away with it, and it was a bit late from Scotland, but they got their hand away, and I didn't see a red flag. As we came into the final changeover, it was an early take from England. Scotland just clean as well, well inside the zone. Down the home straight. It was comfortable for England in the end. And it would be gold for England, silver for Scotland, England under 20 team.
Not sure I quite agree with that, Scott, but I'll take your word for it. I'm with Abby and Millie of the 4x1 team. Girls, great run, first of all. It's always special to beat Scotland, I know, wear that England vest and get that gold medal. Head-to-head, that battle is everything, isn't it, England-Scotland under 20? How satisfying is the win?
It's great, yeah. I mean, we first got together yesterday, like first time we'd met. We had a last minute swap out as well for Mallory on last leg. So yeah, worked hard to get the bat around. It worked.
We made it round.
Yeah, we made it round safe.
And what is a 4x1 like to run in? Because it's my favourite event to watch. It's so exciting to watch. Is it nerve-wracking to be a part of?
Obviously it's nerve-wracking to, because you don't want to let the rest of your team down, but it's so exhilarating when like you all do well, and it's just so much fun because you're all in a team together.
Always helps when you win a gold as well. Congratulations, girls. Let's watch the boys.
Thank you.
One more attempt at 2 meters and 12. Well, this is the senior women's 100 meter hurdles final, and good lineup here actually. Mallory Cluley of GB Juniors in 2, Megan Mars of Northern Ireland in 3, Alicia Barrett of England in 4, Jenna Blundell from the National Athletics League in 5, Holly Mills for England in 6, Heather Patton in to play for. There's a lot of action left, and we're finishing around about 9 o'clock tonight, just after. Cluley in 2, Mars, Barrett, Blundell, Mills, Patton and Evans. Away, first time of asking. Mars getting off to a flying start, Patton going well. Holly Mills getting in to her running now through the middle. Jenna Blundell looks like she might just have the edge here, and as they come across the line, it's going to be tight. Blundell gets there, Barrett closing quickly, 13.23 on the clock. and that is just outside her lifetime best. Jenna Blundell, in the shape of her life, coming here to the Manchester International, and she comes away with the win for the National Athletics League. Well, it was always... Well, this is the replay of the women's 100 metre hurdles. Blundell in the middle had all the main protagonists either side of her. Had a lot of work to do because it was closely run between Barrett, Mills and Blundell, but Barrett and Blundell just...